So good afternoon, everyone. We're here today with Direct Mikhail Red.
Yay!
For tonight's camera magic.
Okay, Direct, please get 10 questions one by one, and then wala po tayong time. Feel free.
Can you share the quirky sides of Bea Alonzo and Ma'am Charo while on set?
Yeah. You're working with them
for the movie. Yeah, so naka-work ko si Bea and Ma'am Charo for my fourth feature film, Eerie. It's actually my first time working with the both of them. Actually, ang dami, pero sige, let's start with Bea. Si Bea, natatawa siya pag, kasi meron ng directing style where pag gusto ko ng take two, medyo sinasugarcoat ko. Okay. Tapos natatawa siya sa fact na yun every time hindi, parang dinadaan ko sa joke. Ganun. So very light yung feeling niya. She's a very technical actress, pero when you direct her, and then, yun yun, nagtatake two, nagtatake three, okay lang naman sa kanya. Pero like, lagi siyang magjo-joke just to keep it light, keep the energy light. Kay Ma'am Charo naman, well, at first, syempre na-intimidate ako. I mean, it's Ma'am Charo, and as a new filmmaker, very intimidating yung idea of directing her. But I was really lucky na I had the opportunity to have her in my film. Siya naman yung type na ano, na hindi siya na-frustrate. Like, even if parang may very, kasi very specific ako mag-direct, so may specific instruction, even if like may minimal error, as in, tatawa lang siya on cam. Titingin siya sa lens, tatawa siya, ganun. So, at first, kala ko very, ano siya, strict and intimidating. Pero, yun, after a few shooting days with her, ang ganda ng pakiramdam. So, actually, very similar silang dalawa.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Next question, Direk. Second.
If you could direct a comedy film, who would your lead stars be and where would it be set? Tricky. Anytime. Gusto gumawa ng ano, buddy cop. Pero medyo unorthodox na casting ha. Parang i-imagine ko si Baron Geiser and Kiko Matos. Pero partnered as police officers.
Okay.
And they're supposed to parang, they're forced to be partners by a police chief, and then action comedy. Ganun yung na-imagine ko. So, buddy cop film. Kasi very rare yung mga buddy cop film dito sa local cinema.
Yeah. Okay. Your third question. If
you got the opportunity to remake a classic, which one would you go for? Magic Temple.
Bakit Magic Temple, Direk? All-time favorite po ba?
And siya yung closest to parang recreating a saga na parang Harry Potter or Star Wars natin. So, isa siya sa gusto kong itakal. Hopefully, one day magawa.
Okay. Fourth question, Direk.
Dapat na hindi ka nang binabas. Do you think it is essential to go to a film institute in order to become a successful filmmaker? Ako personally kasi drop out from college. Pero, huwag niyong gayahin yun. Education is important. I think, kailangan mo lang yung fundamentals ng filmmaking. Basically, you have to know the rules, diba, before you break them. So, may workshops naman, diba, to teach the basics of parang visual storytelling. Mm-hmm. Pero if hindi yun accessible, information nowadays kasi libre na lang. Kahit mag-YouTube lang kayo, ang dami nyong matututunan, ang dami nyong makikita mga video essays on filmmaking. And just, you know, keep watching movies kasi ang pinaka-important naman as a director is your voice and your taste. So develop your taste. Watch a lot of movies.
Okay.
Then,
good tip from direct.
Four.
Down. Tip.
Wow, this way. What are your discoveries upon having the chance to work with your Eerie cast? Well, aside dun sa perks kanina, yun lang, natutunan ko na huwag mo starstruck. I mean, huwag kang tuloy-tuloy ma-starstruck. Siyempre, okay lang ma-starstruck sa simula. It's my first time kasi working with a mainstream studio with this film. Pero, challenging siya, di ba, as a young filmmaker. Pero always make sure lang na nakikita ng team and ng cast na you know what you want, di ba? You know what you're doing and may vision ka. And then, maniniwala sila sa'yo. Tuloy-tuloy lang yun. So, okay lang ma-starstruck sa simula. Pero when on set, make sure, be in control. Yun lang naman.
Sixth question, Derek.
Apart from horror, which kind of film would you be willing to make for Bea, Ma'am Charo, and Josh Lia? All in one film?
Pwede pong combine. Isa-isa. Kukombine better.
Well, gagawa kaming Josh Lia zombie. Hindi siya like really horror. It's more suspense slash post-apocalyptic. With Bea and Ma'am Charo. Well, Bea gusto rin gumawa ng romantic drama. And Ma'am Charo, siguro aside from horror, gusto ko siya ilagay sa mga parang heist thriller. Villain siya.
Okay.
Something like that.
Okay. Seventh.
What's your favorite film, local and international? Local. Local, siguro either Kiss at Mata or Manila sa Kopo ng Liwanag. International, No Country for Old Men. And Whiplash.
Okay.
Tatlo ba?
Yes. Seven. Eight.
How did you come up with the idea for your film Birdshot? Actually, lagi yung tinatanong sa mga Q&A after screening. So, basically, ano siya? May nakita akong article sa news about a Bukidnon farmer who shot, killed, and then niluto niya yung Philippine eagle, kinain niya. Na-jail siya, pero syempre claim niya na unaware siya, na illegal yun. And na-fascinate lang ako sa situation yun, kasi very morally complex, diba? I mean, everyone's a victim, both yung mga uneducated na communities na living near the wilderness na hindi nila alam nga na illegal yun. And for the conservationists, you know, trying to save the Philippine eagle. So, mahilig ako sa mga film na, you know, may moral ambiguity mga characters. So, lagi mas interesting yung plot and yung outcome. Mahirap i-predict. Kasi challenge siya sa viewers, di ba? Pang ano gagawin mo kung ikaw yung nasa situation na yun.
Okay. Ninth. Second to the last.
Which book would you love to make a film out of one day? Hindi pa naging film. Well, hindi siya book. Mas memoir siya about an FBI agent sa US na nagsulat tungkol sa tatay niya na doctor na yung doctor na yun, naging prime suspect ng isang serial killing case sa Hollywood, yung Black Dahlia. And then, pumunta siya sa Philippines noong 1960s. Actually, nag-stay yung prime suspect dito for almost 30 years. Hanggang sa 90s, namatay dito, old age. So parang may idea ako na what if may active serial killer for 30 years tapos hindi napapansin ng police kasi nga ginamit niyang cover yung mga disappearances sa martial law. But yung cool thing is magagawa na to next year.
Okay. Last question, Rick.
How much do you compromise as a filmmaker because of financial restrictions or business, yung economic side ng filmmaking? All the time. I mean, di mawawala yun. Syempre, yung best version of your film starts sa imagination mo. And then when you put it on paper, madadilute. And then when you shoot it, madadilute ulit. And then pag in-edit mo na, pag ni-release mo, parang small chunk na lang siya of what you originally imagined kasi siyempre perfect sa head mo. So, as a filmmaker, tanggap mo yun. So, I think yung goal is to dream really, really, really big. Diba? Yung saying nga na, ano, you shoot for the moon, aim for the moon, and if you miss, you might hit the stars. Kasi yun yung same logic nun na as long as sobrang laki or sobrang ambitious nang na-imagine mo, even if nadadilute siya, in each stage and lagi may compromises, yung end product will still be fantastic. Kasi to begin with, ang laki naman talaga ng idea. So yun yung advice ko.
Yay! There you have it! Direk Mikael for our OOTV Facebook. Okay, Direk, would you like to invite everyone for your upcoming projects? Anything you're doing right now?
So, re-release namin yung Eerie soon. Wala pang release date kasi yung International Film Festival naman. So it's a horror film produced by Star Cinema and Singaporean partners Aurora Media, starring Bea Alonzo and Manu Charo Santos. So it's a ghost story. Abangan nyo yun. I'm also releasing my fourth feature film, Neo Manila, soon this year, which is an assassin thriller starring Yula Valdez. So, yun naikot na namin abroad. So, finally, we'll bring it home for a local release. And then, we're shooting a zombie movie with Joshua Garcia, Julia Barreto, Ian Veneracion, Maurice Racal. So, it's a very fun and exciting new genre film with all these young stars. And hopefully, we will release it next year. So, it's something new and exciting and a game changer. So I hope when we finally release it, you watch it in cinemas. Pero right now, you can support us by following all our social media pages. Search nyo lang each film. So Block Z for the zombie movie, Neo Manila for the assassin thriller, and Eerie for the ghost story film.